Aye, take
your order,
please.
Hey there, can I have a large toffee latte, please?
Yeah, anything else, mate?
No, thank you.
First one, no, cheers.
Cheers.
Hello, mate.
Hey, bud.
219,
please. Take a look at this.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Alright, next one.
Thanks so much. Thanks so much. Cheers, everyone. Right, so I don't know how much of that actually got recorded or not, but I was went to the drive-thru, oh my god, to get a coffee because I had no milk left at my house, obviously. And I remember that I have this flask in here. Well, I remembered far too late. I realised, not remembered, I'd never remembered anything. But I only had water in it as of yesterday evening, so it's still pretty clean inside. So I'm going to transfer this into this because I made a coffee in this yesterday morning at like 5:15 in the morning before I left for work. And this was still, it wasn't warm, but it wasn't cold at like 3 in the afternoon. Whereas I had one of these as well from when I got to work, like 6:30 yesterday. Let's not talk about that. And this was cold before 9. So I'm going to pour that into that. Why not, right? Here we go, fuck. Wow, it looks good actually. I don't know how much you can see here, but look at that on top. Looks bloody beautiful. Oh, wow. This could go horrendously wrong. Oh shit, okay, here we go. And quickly, I think. Speed is gonna be important here. Oh yeah, beauty. You absolutely, that could have gone horribly wrong. Yeah. Yeah, I could have very easily been pouring very hot drink all over myself in the middle of my car there, but I didn't, so all's well.
I have rediscovered my new favorite thing. And that is well done, high quality music mashups. They're just amazing. They tick all my boxes.
Honestly, right, there's a playlist, or probably multiple playlists, on SoundCloud of like, I say amateur, but not only because they're not, I guess they're not professional ones, but they're very high quality mixes of songs that you would never think to compare the two together. So like, for example, The Bird Is The Word mashed up with Skrillex Bangarang. It was an absolute belter. Honestly, check them out. If I can find anything, I will link them down below. But they're so good. I hope I can dig them out again and make them on my regular playlist because I felt so good this morning listening to those at store. It was really, really good. But now work is done. I have not done anything with my lunch this time. I just went to McDonald's because I'm a terrible person. But this could be the last McDonald's I have for quite some time. So I thought I may as well because I'm a fat lazy bugger. Instead, now I'm going to head home. I'm going to pop into Asda to get some cat food because although I can't be bothered getting food for myself, I'm going to get cat food because she needs some food. And then I'll be going back for my regular nap and then heading over to my dad's. I might just have to do a very small bit of cleaning again today, but again, I will see how we go. But time is ticking. I have to move on and I'll see you very shortly. So I'm at Asda and I did get cat food. That's fine. All sorted. Not to worry about some milk and some coffee as well because I need that stuff. But I also saw this. It's a, I can't even fit it all in the shot right now. Look at this thing. It's a freaking huge soundbar. It's called a TV soundbar. It's a 16 watt speaker. So it's not a massive one, but the best speaker I've got at home right now is a 4 watt. And my TV one, I don't know what wattage that is, but I know that it's garbage. And this was a tenner, only a tenner. Now I do want to check it because it says it's Bluetooth, which is amazing, but it doesn't say it has 3.5 mil in, so I'm just checking that it does have an aux skip in there. It does. In fact, it's even got a USB port. What does that do? Service only. Okay, never mind. But I mean, I'm not gonna fully open it out here, but that is obscene. Like, how good is that? I'm super excited for that. I've been looking for a speaker for ages for that TV because it makes the worst noises, but it does have 3.5 millimeter in, which is fantastic. Even comes with a cable for it as well. I just read the thing on the side. It does actually say that it does have 3.5 mm aux in. So that is bloody brilliant. I've dropped down there. Tenner for that. I was prepared to pay way more than that. I nearly bought one for 40 quid not too long ago, but a tenner. Even if it's not amazing quality, I can still bring it nearer because it's detachable. Also, it's Bluetooth, so I might try and get like a Bluetooth transmitter that I can plug into the TV and just have it actually share from the TV to this. Then I can just leave this like sitting on the table in front of us so we can get really good sound next to us. Yeah, made up with that.
Okay, nap out of the way, kind of. I didn't really get much of a nap. I'm more of a, just a lie down and a rest and just think about things, and then I'm good. Hopefully that'll be enough to get through the night. I'm sure it will, but it is now 5:30. I have basically no time to clean and tidy. But whatever, I'm sure I'll be fine. But in the post, I did actually today just receive all this junk that I've just bought. So what this is a thing called Huel, which is essentially food. It's a meal replacement. It's not designed for like losing weight, although if you wanted to cut back on the calories, you could just have small doses of this. If you wanted to bulk up for protein and muscle gain, you could eat a lot of this, I guess, but I'm not using it for any of that thing. I'm not trying to lose weight. I'm not trying to be healthier. I'm not trying to get muscly. I'm just bored of food, right? So I just can't be bothered. So with this, right, because this is, it isn't like designed to make you, isn't like an actual diet thing. It is just, it's just food. It's a meal replacement. It's human fuel. That's why it's Huel. I just clicked. I got the fuel closeness, but I didn't know what the H meant. But yeah, that must be it. It's just people fuel. It's hope. I mean, I'm assuming fairly tasteless. I got original, which is brackets mild vanilla. Then I've got regular vanilla, which is very vanilla-y. And then we've also got down here some little taster samples of flavours you can add to it. And then over here, I've actually got some very generic-looking bars. Just nutritionally complete food bars. It also came with a big old spout mug thing, some measuring jugs for the powder, a little manual thing about how to eat food, and I've not shown it, but also a t-shirt as well with a Huel on it, which is nice. It's a good quality. It's just a regular Gildan one, but you know, a bit of advertising for Huel, I suppose, but whatever, I'll wear it under some shirts, I'm sure. But yeah, the idea behind this, for me at least, is going to be breakfast and lunch. So it'd be my breakfast in the morning, so I don't have to sit down and prepare toast or sandwiches or cereal or anything like that. I can drink this whilst I'm like getting ready, so I can hopefully maybe an extra half an hour lie-in, perhaps? I don't know. We'll see how I go. I'm also tempted to try mixing it with coffee first thing in the morning and see if I can get a coffee like breakfast so I can be drinking that in the car maybe. So I'll have a coffee as normal. Then I'll have this food with caffeine in it. I don't know, maybe. And then, of course, it'll be lunch at work too. So don't have to see me wandering to Mackey's, which is like right next door to the shop I work at. And save me going to McDonald's or save me going to Sainsbury's and spending like £10 there on loads of cookies and stuff. I can just drink my Huel. Is the plan. That's my idea. I might even drink it in the evenings too because I'm lazy enough. I can sit in front of the computer and just drink my dinner whilst I'm gaming. I'll do that, I'm sure. But I will still have regular meals every now and then too. I'll still have proper food. And I'm hoping that what this will do is that when I actually do come around to eating real food again for those few times a week, I'll actually be bothered to make the effort to actually make real good food. I'll actually cook real meats and things rather than just ready meals. So fingers crossed that this will be my fuel for the week and the mornings and the days. And then when I actually want food, I will really enjoy that food and I want to take the effort to make good food up for myself. That's my thought behind it anyway. So that will be breakfast first thing tomorrow morning. I'm not going to try it now because I'm about to head to my dad's in about sort of half an hour or so. So I'll have some food there, some real food there. And that'll be my last meal. No, it won't be last meal. And I am still... Wow, that was loud. I am still going to be eating regular food. I'm not dieting. I'm not cutting out things. I'm not replacing all my meals with it. Although apparently you can. Apparently it does contain literally every vitamin and nutrient that humans need. It contains the exact right amount of calories if you have the right dosages of it. It contains like a little bit of fat just to keep you ticking over. A little bit of sugar to keep you ticking over. Just in theory, you can live off the stuff. I wouldn't want to because that would be really, really boring. There's some little flavor sachets I've got to try out and see what they're like. But in theory, you could. I plan on replacing probably two meals a day for it. And then, what's going on? You coming up or not? There you go. Yeah, I plan on replacing one to two meals a day for it. Maybe three on some lazy days, if I like it. But if it turns out it's gross and like I can't drink it because it's just horrible, then it'll be dead in the water and I won't bother carrying it on. But I thought it worth a shot. I thought it was a nice idea. I thought it'd be fun to try it out. And I got a good bargain for it too. I got £10 off my first order. The shirt, the mixer, the jug and the little stirrer things. And the sachets of food, of flavour, sorry, were all sort of free extras. So I got it for, I think I paid about £45 total for two huge bags of stuff, which should last, if it was three meals a day, it would last, I think it's about a week and a half if I do three meals a day. So if I do two meals a day with the occasional day off, it should actually be straight over to about sort of 2 or 3 weeks. So £45 for 3 weeks of food, that's a good deal. I'm spending with my ready meal in the evening and all my lunch and then breakfast too, I'm spending sort of like 10, 15 pounds a day at the moment, whereas it'd be more like £2 a day. So I think that's going to be a good idea. But as long as I like it, if I don't, then it's going in the bin, probably. Now onto the soundbar that I bought. So the issue I have with this is that for some reason, when I wire it into this dusty TV, it sounds like arse. I don't understand why. If I plug my phone into the cable that it comes with, it sounds great. If I Bluetooth to it, it sounds great. If I plug the cable into the TV, it sounds like a bag of dicks. And I haven't quite worked out why yet, so I'm going to play around with that a little bit. Because there's still hope. It does sound great with the phone, but the TV, it does not. So I'm going to need to have a sort of work out what's going on with that, I'm sure. I'm thinking at the moment maybe the port that has the audio out in the back of my head, the headphone jack basically on the TV, I'm thinking might be a bit knackered. So I need to look into that. I'll try some other speakers and see if they sound as terrible too. And if it is, then that's going to be the issue, isn't it? And even Bluetooth won't save it then, which is a shame because I did buy the soundbar for the TV. So if that's the one unit I can't use it with, then I'm going to regret buying it. But it was a tenner, so I really can't argue with it. I'm sure I'll find use for it. Hell, if I really can't find use for it in-house, which I'm sure I will, I'll take it to work and use it in the stock room because we always put speakers in there when we're down there for a long time anyway. So I'll have use for it there, but I'd rather keep it at home if I can. Oh, right. Well, that is it from me for today, I'm afraid. What time is it now? It is about 10 to 11. I was on the wrong screen on my watch, so I couldn't see the time because smartwatches take more effort to see the time on them. Go figure. But yeah, that is it for me for today. Just been to my dad's and we played a game called Rhyme. If you've played The Witness, it has some sort of vibes about that around it. Yes, I knew. Yeah. I don't know. Yeah, it's got some notes of The Witness to it, but much easier than The Witness. If you played The Witness and finished it, then you will walk through Rhyme. But it is fun. It's a good little game. We got through two significant chunks of it, so happy with that. And now I'm off to bed because first thing in the morning I have to get up fairly early, not early as early as normal for work, but I'll be up about 7, I think, that's my alarm for. So I'll have a nice little lie-in and recovery from the earlies this week. Then we'll get up and I'm going to try my Huel for the first time, see what that paste is like. And then the last minute clearing up the house, and last minute packing up for the weekend. And then setting up the cat wheel for the food for tomorrow and Sunday daytime. And then I'll be off to work and then over to Jersey's. So we've got a bit planned this weekend at least. We're going to go travel centre on Saturday. Jo needs to get some more makeup and things because she went flying to Scotland the other day and forgot that you couldn't take liquids on the plane. So it had to bin like maybe £200 worth of makeup. So that sucks so bad. Like, that's a real shit at that. But mistakes are made. Anyway, that's it from me. I hope you enjoyed. If you have, a like rating is always very appreciated. Just click that thumb down below. It's always very, very appreciated. And if you haven't subscribed yet and you're still liking this content, please do consider subscribing. It'd be nice to get that number 10 to a number 11, particularly as one of them is me. So, you know, better to make it a real 10. But yeah, thank you very much for watching. And I'll see you all later.